Dr. Ravikant Pathak, and I am working in the Excel Academy Private Limited and Tuticorin, Tamil Nadu. So, in the last video, we have discussed about the reproduction of the algae and reproduction of the algae, and I will discuss in this video about the thallus different structure. So, different thallus structure of the algae here. So we will discuss in this video about the different thallus, means the range of thallus structure in the algae. And you know very well, so algae is the thallophyta. Algae considered is a thallophyta, and thallophyta means you can say here the plant body which is not differentiated into root, stem and leaf, that is called thallophyta. Clear? Thallophyta, that means those plants which is not differentiated into root, stem and leaf, that is called thallophyta. So structure, that is the structure of the algae. So it means you can say algae plant body appears like thallus. Algae plant body appears like thallus. So due to this you can say, so we will discuss, you can say this is the thallophyta, it belongs from the thallophyta. And we will see in this topic, so different types of the thallus structure of algae. Clear? And you know algae mostly maybe unicellular or multicellular. Some algae are unicellular or multicellular. Clear? So unicellular, if you check the unicellular, so unicellular also two different type. Unicellular algae also two different type. One is the motile, another is the non-motile. Motile means chlamydomonas. If you see the motile means chlamydomonas. And you know very well chlamydomonas that have the two flagella. With the help of flagella they can locomote. Okay, they can movements, they can perform the locomotion. And you can also here you can say one thing also found in the chlamydomonas, cup shaped chloroplast found in the chlamydomonas. And chlamydomonas have the flagella. Due to this it show the function of locomotion. Clear? Second, I have given the non-motile algae, that is the chlorella. And we have already discussed this chlorella about the economic importance of the algae. So you can read about the chlorella. And you know chlorella, so chlorella, they don't have the flagella. It means they can't move. And chlorella have the good content of the protein. Due to this, it used as a space food. Astronauts, they have already used. So due to rich content of the protein, it considered as a space food. And is also used by the astronauts. Clear? So this is the unicellular alga. First is the motile and second is the non-motile. Motile chlamydomonas and non-motile is the chlorella. So non-motile is the chlorella. So next, if you'll see the multicellular alga, they have also different type. So one is the non-motile colony and motile colony. Motile colony means wall box. Wall box also have the flagella. Wall box also have the flagella, and these are the multicellular. So with the help of flagella, it can perform the locomotion. Clear? Non-motile colony is the pediastrum. Non-motile colony is the pediastrum. And if you'll check the amorphous colony, amorphous, you know very well in the physics, you already studied about the solid state. So in the physics or chemistry, you already studied different types of the state. So you know crystal structure. So some crystal are the amorphous, some solid have the crystalline structure, and some have the amorphous structure. So amorphous structure means you can say easily brittle. So here amorphous colony means this is not aggregate. It is not good aggregate. Clear? An example is the microcystis. So microcystis is considered as a amorphous colony. Clear? One thing, dendrite colony. Dendrite, you know, in case of the dendron where found in the exon, dendron, cytron. Clear? So this also form the dendrite colony, and this found in the dinobryon. Okay, where it found? It found in the dinobryon. So dinobryon, this generally show the which type of colony? It show the dendrite colony. Clear? And next, which is the very important, this next colony Next, multicellular colony is the very important filamentous. Filamentous, so in the filamentous, they have the three. Ulothrix, Spirogyra and Ectocarpus. Ulothrix, Spirogyra and Ectocarpus. So these are considered as a unbranched and multicellular filamentous structure. Unbranched multicellular filamentous structure. These have given the example. So here Ulothrix, Spirogyra and Ectocarpus. Here I have not mentioned Ectocarpus, but you should to know Ectocarpus also considered as a multicellular filamentous unbranched algae. And Ectocarpus belong which group? So Ectocarpus belong the class Phaeophysi, brown algae. Clear? So it means you can say here that is the Spirogyra, Ulothrix, and one more also Ectocarpus. So these belong the filamentous multicellular unbranched algae. So filamentous multicellular unbranched algae. And one thing also, they have given the simple branched algae. So it means it will check the suppose that this is the algae and they have the simple branch like this. So this is called the simple branched algae, that is called Cladophora. And one also have given the example that is called pseudobranched. It will check their example. So it have given the pseudobranched algae. So pseudobranched means they have the false branch, not actual branch. Clear? They have not actual branching. They have the false branching. It means you can say here this algae, that is the pseudobranched. So pseudobranched means they have not actual branch. So it means suppose that this is the algae. This is the algae. Okay. And here they have like this branch. Means you can't differentiate branching. So that it's called pseudobranched. Pseudobranched. An example is the Cytonema. So Cytonema is the example of the pseudobranched multicellular filamentous algae. Clear? So this here you can say these are three very important. USE. USE is very important. Why I am saying important? Because they already asked in the NEET examination 2 to 4 times. Clear? So due to this, Ulothrix, Spirogyra, Ectocarpus, filamentous, multicellular and unbranched algae. Clear? So this is the very, very important. Okay. So next if we'll see the heterotrichous. What means of the heterotrichous? Heterotrichous means if we'll see this type of the chara. Example, they have given the chara. So suppose that this is the algae. This is the algae. And algae, they have the two different types of the branching. Means one branching is the prostrate manner. Prostrate means creeping manner. And another is the erect. So due to this saying heterotrichous. Hetero means different. Trichous means branch. So here one branch is the prostate and another is the erect. So due to this, it is called the heterotrichous. An example is the chara. So example, they have given the chara. One thing also have given the siphonous. Siphonous means suppose that this is the algae. And in case of the siphonous, so sometimes they form the new filament. But there is no formation of the wall. No formation of the septation. Septation means septa. So here no formation of the septa takes place. And there what will condition will come. So suppose that nucleus continue divide. And these nucleus continue divide forms one condition which is known as the synocytic condition. So siphonous, so Voucheria, so which type of condition? Voucheria, so synocytic condition. And synocytic means multinucleated condition. You already studied in the fungus. In the fungus, synocytic hyphae. So it means in the siphonous, there is the rapid division of nucleus takes place. And this forms the synocytic condition. And it found where? It found in the Voucheria. Clear? It found in the Voucheria. So next is have given the pseudoparenchymatous means only particular direction. And parenchymatous division is the 3D. Parenchymatous division is the 3D direction. Means everywhere, every direction found parenchymatous. And they have given the example. Parenchymatous example is the alva. Alva also known as sea lettuce. Clear? So parenchymatous example is the alva. And alva also called sea lettuce. So common name of alva is the sea lettuce. and pseudo parenchymatous, so they have the false means that means particular knot, not like 3D, they have the particular two or less than one direction. So this is called the pseudo parenchymatous. And here they have given the example. If we check the example, so their example is the monostroma. Their example is the monostroma. Clear? So it means you have already seen so different types of the structure. And in your NEET examination, so they have asked. Already asked and probability, so 100% probability it may be asked. Okay, it may be asked. So you should learn thoroughly and instantly, because this is the very important. Okay, and now your class is going to finish, and for my channel, so to subscribe and hit the bell icon for regular updates. So thank you for students for their